Good morning. Today we are going to study wave nature of light. First, what is the meaning of visible light? Visible light, it is one of the waves present in the electromagnetic spectrum, and its wavelengths range between 380 to 700 nanometers. So the visible light has a wavelength between 380 and 700 nanometers. Speed of light or the light velocity, it is the distance covered by the light in 1 second. So V equal D, which is distance, over T, which is time. And the light velocity in the space or vacuum equal 3 × 10⁸ meter per second. Now we will talk about analysis or splitting of white light. Analysis or splitting of white light. We can split or analyze white light by a glass prism. The glass prism helps to split light into 7 spectral colors. So the white light, which is the light of the sun, and the sun is the main source of light on Earth, consists of 7 spectral colors, which are red, orange, yellow, green, blue, and white. Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, and white. The red color, it is the longest wavelength and the lower frequency. So the red light has the longest wavelength and low frequency. And it is close to the apex of the prism. And the violet color, it is close to the base of the prism, has high frequency and short wavelengths. High frequency and short wavelengths. Energy of light wave. We have a German scientist which called Max Planck. He proved that the energy of light consists of quantum of energy called photons. Again, Max Planck proved that the energy of light wave consists of quantum of energy known as photons. And the energy of the photon is directly proportional to the frequency of light wave. So Max Planck proved that the photon energy equal constant times frequency, because photon energy and frequency are directly proportional. So, give reason, the photon of red light less than the photon of violet light. Why? Because the frequency of red light is less than the frequency of violet light. Real life application. Light can be used in home decoration, like use of the spotlight to illuminate the artifacts, and use the stand light to concentrate light while reading. So this is the real life application of light. What is the light behavior in different media? We have 3 different media in light. We have transparent media and opaque media and semi-transparent or translucent. What is the difference between these 3 media? First, transparent media. Transparent media like air, water, it is the media which allows most the light to pass through. So we can see clearly through it. The semi-transparent or translucent medium, like a tissue or flint glass. It is the medium which allows parts of light to pass through and absorb the other part. So the vision here is less clear. The opaque medium. The opaque medium is the medium which doesn't allow medium is a medium which doesn't allow any light to pass through. Light, book, milk, your skin, wood, plastic, and so on. Give reason, although the water is transparent medium, we can't see fish at the bottom of the river. Why? Why we can see fish in the bottom of the river? Why the water is transparent? Because as the thickness increases, the thickness of the medium increases, the ability of light to pass through it decreases. Okay? As we say before, or as we said before in grade 5, that light travels in a straight line, as this picture. If we get a light source and three different or four different sheets which has holes in it and different sizes of holes, small, bigger, and so on, we will notice that we see the light through these sheets. Why? Because light travels in a straight line. And also we noticed that we can control the size of the light, or we can control the thickness of the light by controlling the size of the holes in these sheets. So we can see light area of light increased by increasing the size of the hole. So light travels through transparent medium in form of a straight line, which size can be controlled by controlling the size of the holes. Light intensity. Can we control the light intensity? Yes. As we said before in the sound, the inverse square law of sound, here also we have inverse square law of light, which is light intensity of a surface is inversely proportional to the square of the distance. Light intensity is inversely proportional to the square of distance. So light intensity increases when the distance decreases, and sine of light intensity decreases when the distance increases. Okay? So in light intensity we have inverse square law of light as sound. And this is for today. See you next time. Goodbye.